Moin, welcome. Hello and welcome. This podcast is for motivated people who want to improve their Luxembourgish vocabulary, listening skills and fluency by listening to compelling content. I'm Anne, your dedicated host and the driving force behind Luxembourgish with Anne, with a true passion for teaching my mother tongue since 2012. In this dynamic podcast, I'll share with you interesting short vocabulary lessons and topic conversations from level A1 to B1, and together we will build a strong foundation of the language you need to speak with confidence about everyday life topics. I also share exclusive learning strategies and insights for the Spruchentest oral exam. So join me on this exciting Luxembourgish learning journey. Bist du bereit? Are you ready? Moin und willkommen zu dieser Episode Nummer 26. And this is part 2 of 30 common Luxembourgish phrases that you can use in many different situations. I hope that you enjoyed part 1, which I published 2 or 3 weeks ago, where you learned phrases to greet someone, to say how you are feeling, how to apologize and answer back. And also you have learned how to respond to thank you. Okay, so if someone says merci to you, you have three, four, five possibilities to answer back. Do you remember maybe 1, 2, or 3 phrases? So you could say, gern geschieht, my pleasure. Or, das nicht, meaning don't mention it. Or, more formal, kein Ursach. You're welcome. Okay, so if you haven't listened to that podcast, maybe you can start with listening to part 1 and then coming back to this part 2. The phrases selected for this episode are for beginners and typical expressions used by native speakers. And did you know that you can get fluent faster if you focus on learning Luxembourgish phrases, the same phrases that native speakers use every day? And I don't recommend that you learn single words. Learn by chunks, okay? Now you can practice listening comprehension and your oral expression by listening to these phrases. Bist du bereit? Dann lass! We will start with 8 phrases for telephone calls. So the first one is an informal, to start an informal call, you can say Salut, hiya stan, means hi, this is Anne. Salut, hiya stan. So use this in an informal situation with friends, colleagues, family members, and so on. Now to start a formal telephone call, you would start with Moin, mein Num, as, and then you add on your name, maybe your last name or your first and last name. For example, Moin, mein Num, as, an Befort. More formal could be Bonjour, mein Num, as, an Befort. I personally always say Moin, mein Num, as, Befort. And then, if you'd like to have an appointment, you would say, Ich hätte gern ein Rendezvous. Ich hätte gern ein Rendezvous. Or if you'd like to speak to someone, you would say, Ich gäf gern mam Herr Weber schwätzen. Ich gäf gern mam Herr Weber schwätzen, meaning I would like to speak with Mr. Weber. Mir wiederholen, Moin, mein Num as Anbefort. Ich hätte gern ein Rendezvous. Or, ich gäf gern mam Herr Weber schwätzen. Sentence number 3 is also formal. Kennt ich mam Mark Weber schwätzen, wann ich gelieft? Kennt ich, meaning could I or may I, mam Mark Weber schwätzen, speak with Mark Weber. So it's formal. And don't forget your wann ich gelieft. Kennt ich mam Mark Weber schwätzen, wann ich gelieft? Or if you would like to speak to a woman and use the formal form, you would say, Kennt ich mit der Madame Weber schwätzen, wann ich gelieft? Kennt ich mit der Madame Weber schwätzen, wann ich gelieft? And then, if you want to say, I'm calling about, this is, Ich rufen u wenst. Ich rufen u veins. So to call is urufen. It's a separable verb. And here we would say, ich rufe u veins da annonce. I'm calling about the ad. Ich rufe u veins da annonce. And then, to say one moment please is, im Moment wann ich glift. Let's repeat, im Moment wann ich glift. Very useful. Okay, and if you want to say that he, let's say Mr. Weber, is not there, you would say jen as net do. Jen as net do, or den Herr Weber as net do. If it's a woman, you would say sie for formal, sie as net do, or Madame Weber as net do. And then you can continue asking the person, shall I leave him a message? Shall I leave him a message? Soll ich him a message Hanna losen? So to leave a message is a message Hanna losen. Shall I leave? Soll ich him a message Hanna losen? And if it's a woman, soll ich hier a message Hanna losen? This is all formal. Okay, good. Now, if you want to say that the person is in a meeting, you would say jen or sie as an enger Reunion. Jen or sie as an enger Reunion. Kennt ihr mich spät nach ein Keier urufen? Meaning, could you call again later? Kennt ihr mich spät, meaning later, nach ein Keier urufen? Remember, urufen means to call, yeah? Könnt ihr mich später noch ein Keer urufen? Wir wiederholen den ganzen Satz. Jen oder sie als an einer Reunion. Könnt ihr mich später noch ein Keer urufen? And the last phrase, the Satz 8, to thank you, to say thank you for calling, formal, you would say merci für Ihren Uruf. Merci für Ihren Uruf. Okay, good. Let's move on and learn 5 phrases for agreeing. So to say exactly, you would say genau, genau. You can also say genau. Some people say genau. This is the German word, but it's also in our dictionary. But I prefer to say genau, so exactly. Mm-hmm. Or to say to someone you are absolutely right is du hast absolut recht. Mir wiederholen, du hast absolut recht. To say, for example, that's true is dat as voa. Dat as voa. Mir wiederholen, dat as voa. Next Satz, to say I agree is ich sin afastan. Ich sin afastan. Mir wiederholen, ich sin afastan. And if you want to say that you agree 100%, you would say ich sin voll domat afastan. Ich sie voll domat afastan. Or you can say ich sie voll domada afastan. Okay? And then a last sentence to say that you agree, to say for example I suppose so is ich hole nun. So I suppose so is ich hole nun. Ich hole nun. And use this phrase for weak agreement. So you agree but reluctantly. Huh? Ich hole nun. Let's repeat these 5 short phrases to say that you agree. So exactly was gene. You are absolutely right is du hast absolut recht. That's true. Do you remember how to say that's true? Dat as voa. I agree. Ich sin afastan. And if you want to say that you agree 100%, you would say ich si voll domat afastan. And the last one, I suppose so. Ich hole nun. Okay, let's move on and learn 5 phrases for disagreeing. For example, if you want to say I don't agree with this, you would say ich sin net domat afastan. Ich sin net domat afastanen. I don't agree with it. Mm-hmm. Or to say I'm not sure about that. Do sin ich mir aber net so sicher. Let's listen and repeat after me. Do sin ich mir aber net so sicher. So I'm not so sure about that. Mir wiederholen den Satz. Do sin ich mir aber net so sicher. And then, not necessarily is net unbedingt. Net unbedingt. Net unbedingt. And even to say no way, you would say op keinen Fall, op keinen Fall. For example, someone is asking you, gehst du matt an das chinesische Restaurant and you don't like Chinese food, you would say op keinen Fall. Okay. And then that's not how I see it, is ich gesehen dat anischt. Ich gesehen dat anischt. Okay, so, and then let's continue by learning five phrases for responding to good news. So the first one is Felicitationen. Felicitationen meaning congratulations. For example, a student of mine has passed the Spruchentest, then I would say Felicitationen. To say my best congratulation is Ming best Glückwunsch. Ming best Glückwunsch. You can use this, for example, when someone has a birthday. Ming best Glückwunsch. To say that pleases me is dat freut mich. Dat freut mich. To say that's great is dat das genial. And more natural, like native speaker would say dat das jo genial. Dat das jo genial. So here you show your enthusiasm to say wow, that's great. And to say awesome in Luxembourgish, you can say mega. It's really commonly used, mega. Okay? Wir wiederholen die fünf Sätze. Donc, congratulations is Felicitationen. My best congratulations is mein best Glückwunsch. That pleases me. Dat freut mich. That's great. Dat das genial, or dat das jo genial. And do you remember how to say awesome? Yes, this is mega. Good. And now let's finish this episode with five phrases for responding to bad news. Okay, so you can say, for example, oh nee. Oh nee. So someone tells you that he didn't pass the exam, so you could say, oh nee. Or you can say, dat das jo schrecklich. That's really terrible. Dat das jo schrecklich. So the jo in a sentence, as we have seen it, dat das jo genial, is just here to stress what you want to express in this phrase. So it doesn't mean yes, okay? So dat das jo schrecklich. So that's really terrible, yeah? And then to say poor you, you can say du armen, if it's a man or boy. And if it's a woman or girl, you can say du armt, so if it's a woman, and if it's a man, du armen. So use this to respond to bad situations that are not too serious. Okay, so du armen or du armt. We often use this also for children, for example. Let's continue by learning how to say I'm sorry. I'm sorry is dat dit mir leid. Dat dit mir leid. Or to say I'm so sorry. Dat dit mir aber so leid. Dat dit mir aber so leid. So I'm so sorry. And a last phrase to respond to bad news, for example, to say my sincere condolences. So use this when one of your family member or friend or colleague passed away. Then you would say, mein herzlichst Beileid. Listen and repeat after me. Mein herzlichst Beileid. Mein herzlichst Beileid. Great. Now, I hope that you enjoyed this episode and that you find these phrases useful. And don't listen only once to this podcast, to this episode. Listen several times so that you can remember those phrases, especially the ones for the telephone calls, for agreeing or disagreeing are very important, but also the ones to respond to good news and to bad news. Okay. Good. Now, don't forget that on my website you can discover all the course and class options Luxembourgish with Anne offers. And yes, and I am looking forward to working maybe with you in the upcoming future or to prepare you for your upcoming Spruchentest session. Now, merci für Lauschen. Thank you for listening. Bis next Woche. Adi.